Each time when I come here, I am abused.
Today in Texas, the United States Postal Service has literally worked a man to death. This is a sad, sad story of a postal carrier in Texas named Eugene. He died thanks to working conditions in the extreme heat in Texas, shortly after receiving a disciplinary letter for taking too many breaks because of the heat. Here's a picture of the man. His wife Carla said, "The love of my life is gone." And in case you're wondering, at 7:30 in the morning when they started work, it's already 88 degrees. He had been carrying letters for the post office for 36 years in Dallas, Texas. He purchased an ice maker for his home so that every day he could take a cooler full of ice just to try to survive as he does his job. If you didn't know, most of our postal trucks are a very old design and they do not have air conditioning, and even the ones that do, the door and windows open the whole dang day. It's not going to stay very cold in that metal box. Also, while we're calling out the post office, they did raise the price of the Forever Stamp recently. Additionally, recently Texas was the hottest place on the planet. And you know what else Texas just did? They removed protections for workers within the state during times of extreme heat. Because fuck the workers, right? Right? That's how we want to play this? Today in Texas...
Blistering temperatures and weighed down by heavy mailbags, this postal carrier collapsed and died during the excessive heat warning in Texas.
66-year-old Eugene Gates was delivering mail in a Dallas neighborhood when he collapsed in the front yard. Now there's new concern for mail carriers working outdoors in soaring temperatures with no air conditioning.
It was a stifling 115 degrees when the veteran postal worker succumbed. A neighbor who provided this ring cam called Gates the sweetest man and says she'd often give him a wet towel and water to help him cool down. Texans are used to hot weather, but the combination of humidity and triple-digit temperatures is making for an unprecedented heat wave across the entire state. Incredibly, there is no air conditioning in mail trucks. Kemetra Lewis is with the National Association of Letter Carriers.
How difficult is it for postal carriers when they have to deal with this horrible heat?
It's unbearable.
What do you think should be done?
I do think that the Postal Service should stress to letter carriers that it's okay to take additional rest breaks to cool off.
Cardiologist Dr. Ridved Tadwalker says it's imperative to recognize the signs of a heat stroke.
One of the major symptoms is hot and dry skin and an inability to cool itself due to lack of sweating. But other symptoms include nausea, vomiting, headache, rapid heartbeat, and shallow breathing.
In response to the death of Eugene Gates, mail carriers in the area can now start their day an hour earlier at 7:30 a.m. to try to beat the heat. But that's little comfort for the family of this beloved letter carrier.
Hours. So we'll have to keep it pretty compressed. If folks want to learn more, they can go to From A to Arbitration, anywhere you get podcasts, and listen to some more detail. But what are some of the highlights of some of the things that you and members are the most frustrated with from the NALC over the last few years?
Yeah, I would say that and it's funny you say that, because I always tell my listeners, I was like, I'm gonna make this a short episode, and it'll be 3 hours long, because I get to, you're going to have to make sure I stay reined in. Okay. And so, I would say that one of the biggest examples, would be this, HIP training that management is required to do every April 1st. And it's, heat illness prevention training. And, we had a death of a brother down in Dallas, Mr. Gates, and I don't know if you've heard that episode. I don't know how many you listened to, but he passed away due to the heat. And This gentleman was on the verge of retirement. And the first thing that management came out and said was, it kind of put the blame on him, where they said that he had received this HIP training, so there's no reason for this to happen, basically. Only to find out that management falsified his HIP training. And we have found over this country, a majority of the carriers' training had been falsified. Management went in and said that the carriers had received training when in fact they didn't. And so that was one of the biggest things I was railing on, was the fact that we need to do something nationally, whether we need to get out into the streets and mobilize on behalf of not only our brother, Mr. Gates, who passed away, but because of how management was treating our safety issues. That's just one example as far as the safety issues are concerned. But our president refused to acknowledge that this training was first falsified, and the fact that we needed to get in the streets and mobilize and let the people of the country know what was going on as far as our working conditions. And so I was irate about that. I thought that our president should be presidential and be out front and take us into the streets and let the public know that we are, our working conditions are third world country type things. We had an email that I read on one of my episodes the other day where one of the managers, an upper management, sent out an email stating that they wanted us out of the office in an hour. That's completely fabricated. They made that up. Well, he sends out an email and said, you know, everybody wants to stay in the cool air. Cut the air conditioner off on the letter carriers and force them out of the office.
Wow.
And so that's what we deal with all the time. Brother, I could stay on here for 4 hours telling you stuff like examples of stuff like that. But our president is non-existent. We also have this route adjustment.
We are learning new information about a postal worker who was shot and killed earlier this week. Now, you're looking at video of what appears to be a burned out white Dodge Durango spotted on the south side. Chicago police are investigating whether this is the vehicle they've been looking for.
On July 19th, 2024, Octavia Ridman, 40 years of age, was delivering mail in the 12,000 block of Harvard in the West Pullman neighborhood when she was ambushed and shot multiple times at the age of 48.
Hi folks, your local friendly mailman here. Yes, I'm in the beer cooler. It is that hot. I don't feel good. Taking my own advice, taking a break. I'm exhausted. I think I am actually suffering from slight heat exhaustion. I'm drinking lots of water and I'm just sweating it all out. It's hot. Man, it's cold in here. Wow. So just be safe out there. It is really hot. No job is worth your life. Not even this one. Oh boy. Take care. Bye.
What the fuck? Shit. God damn it. Shit. The fuck? Man, god damn.
What does it mean to you, Derek?
Man, everything, man. I work my ass off, bro.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all. My paycheck looked like I got a good job, but my bills look like I need to be moving bricks for El Chapo. Make it make sense.
Quickly, when I became in the union, I saw the importance of it because, believe it or not, the Postal Service is the most mismanaged organization in the country. I would put it up against anybody as far as it being mismanaged. And if we didn't have the union in the Postal Service, we'd probably be making about $10 an hour. Mm. And that's not a joke. But
one more time, I couldn't hear you.
Now I know. Whew, thank God, work day is over. What a day! Finally, on back to this office and.
Hello. Well, man, I can't wait till we get those new trucks. Because as much as I wanted to be stuck in this cold-ass weather... I have like 4 addresses left. And now I gotta wait on either a tow truck or somebody maybe to jump me. I wonder if I could start a fire in here. If only there was some paper. All right, baby, come on. Currently 14 degrees, feels like -6. Somebody come jump me. I gotta pee. Somebody here to jump me. I gotta do these 5 houses now. I did the last package and it died on me again. But luckily, dude, the jump me's passing back by and he's jumping me again. Alright, about 3 blocks from the office. I just gotta make it to the office.
I'm the Executive Vice President of Branch 34 here in Boston, and I just want to welcome all of you to Boston, and I hope that you guys really all have a great time while you're here.
Welcome, delegates, to Boston, or New England. My name is Jim Langlois, President of Branch 55 in Pawtucket, Rhode Island. In Rhode Island, we're spoiled. We have Federal Hill. We get some great restaurants up there, and I would say the North End can match it, too, with the great Italian food they have up there. And the chowder is great, right? It is. Every time I see someone in Boston, G yet? You hungry?
If I can give you a few suggestions while you're here, you can turn around right out the front door here at the seaport. You can grab a water taxi. You can go right over to the casino. While you're at the casino, if you look across the street, you're going to be able to get the best roast beef you've ever had. You're going to walk into Mike's Roast Beef. You're going to order a roast beef 3-way on an onion roll with seasoned fries and extra cheese on the side. Trust me, you'll thank me.
Make sure you go down to Fenway Park and take a tour and see where the best baseball team in the country plays.
Fenway Park, the best park in all of America, America's most beloved ballpark. It's a place where history is made, not torn down. Fenway opened up 4 days after the Titanic sank in 1912.
Make sure while you're over there, you go and take a tour. When you take the tour, you're going to be able to go out to the Green Monster on the field, walk the entire track. You're going to be able to go out to Pesky's Pole, bring your magic marker, make sure it's a Sharpie so you can make sure you write your name on it.
Come see the Red Sox. They're playing here Friday, the last day of the convention. Go to Fenway Park and see the best baseball and the best park in America.
And then when you have a little time, go down to Boston Garden. You want to go see where the Boston Bruins play and the 18-time world champion Boston Celtics play. So you go see that. That's a little bit of the sport.
When you go over to the Garden, like Rick said, stop into Sullivan's Taps, cheapest beers in town. And while you're at the Garden, you can also go in and see the New England Sports Museum and take a tour there.
But then again, I want you to get down to Faneuil Hall, where we have a lot of bars and you can get a lot of beers and you can have a lot of fun. And after you drink all that beer, you can figure out where to park your car, because that's what we do around here.
You can walk over to the Omni Parker House and get the Boston Cream Pie, the home of the Boston Cream Pie, the original Boston Cream Pie.
You all have an accent this week, because we don't. When you order food at a restaurant, and there's many Italian restaurants down in the area, you get down on the North End, you can go get pastry, stuff that you've never had before. You are going to order food, and the waiters are going to know you are not from Boston, as we speak the proper English, because remember, the Pilgrims landed in Plymouth, Massachusetts, and nowhere else.
Make sure when you're here, don't forget to get your dunks. And when you order that coffee, it's going to be a coffee regular. What that means?
I'm leaving. This place won't be no mail late. The Monday, don't plan on retiring. Cause one day, I'm gonna sing my way out of this place. That's why I and share too. But I'm for real though. Help me.